The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Father, Lord of heaven and earth, by whose gracious will the mysteries of the kingdom are revealed to the childlike, make us learn from your Son humility of heart, that in shouldering his yoke you may find refreshment and rest. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. The introit hymn, hymn number 361. And every one of you. And a warm welcome to this act of worship here today. A special welcome to all those worshiping with us via our Facebook page. Today's the fifth Sunday after Pentecost, and collect and readings are for proper night. I was glad when they said to me, "Let us go to the house of the Lord." Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia. And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit.
that we may
perfectly love
and worthily magnify through Christ our Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God, Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, you have taught us to keep all your commandments by loving you and our neighbor. Grant us the grace of your Holy Spirit, that we may be devoted to you with our whole heart and united to one another with pure affection. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the ministry of the word.
A reading from the Word of God, written in Genesis chapter 24, verses 34 to 38, 42 to 49, 58 to 67. The servant said to Laban, I am Abraham's servant. The Lord has greatly blessed my master, and he has become wealthy. He has given him flocks and herds, silver and gold, male and female slaves, camels and donkeys. And Sarah, my master's wife, has borne a son to my master when she was old, and he has given him all that he has. My master made me swear, saying, you shall not take a wife for my son from the daughters of the Canaanites, in whose land I live, but you shall go to my father's house, to my kindred, and get a wife for my son. I came today to the spring and said, O Lord, the God of my master Abraham, if now you will only make successful the way I am going, I am standing here by the spring of water. Let the young woman who comes to draw, to whom I shall say, please give me a little water from your jar to drink, and who will say to me, drink, and I will draw for your camels also. Let her be the woman whom the Lord has appointed for my master's son. Before I had finished speaking in my heart, there was Rebecca coming out with her water jar on her shoulder, and she went down to the spring and drew. I said to her, please let me drink. She quickly let down her jar from her shoulder and said, drink, and I will also water your camels. So I drank, and she also watered the camels. Then I asked her, whose daughter are you? She said, the daughter of Bethuel, Nahor's son, whom Milcah bore to him. So I put the ring on her nose and the bracelets on her arms. Then I bowed my head and worshiped the Lord and blessed the Lord, the God of my master Abraham, who had led me by the right way to obtain the daughter of my master, kinsman, for his son. Now then, if you will deal loyally and truly with my master, tell me, and if not, tell me, so that I may turn either to the right or to the left. And they called Rebekah and said to her, will you go with this man? She said, I will. So they sent away their sister Rebekah and her nurse, along with Abraham's servant and his men. And they blessed Rebekah and said to her, "May you, O sister, become thousands of myriads. May your offspring gain possession of the gates of their foes." Then Rebekah and her maids rose up, mounted the camels, and followed the man. Thus the servant took Rebekah and went his way. Now Isaac had come from Beer Lahairoi and was settled in the Negev. Isaac went out in the evening to walk in the field, and looking up, he saw camels coming. And Rebekah looked up, and when she saw Isaac, she slipped quickly from the camel and said to the servant, "Who is the man over there walking in the field to meet us?" The servant said, "It is my master." So she took her veil and covered herself. And the servant told Isaac all the things he had done. Then Isaac brought her into his mother Sarah's tent. He took Rebekah, and she became his wife, and he loved her. So Isaac was comforted after his mother's death. The word of the Lord.
Psalm appointed for today is Psalm 45, verses 11 through 18. You and I will read alternate verses. Hear, O daughter, consider and listen closely. Forget your people and your father's house. The people of Tyre are here with a gift. The rich among the people seek your favor. In embroidered apparel, she is brought to the king, and her the bridesmaids follow in procession. In palace of fathers, O king, you shall have sons. You shall make them princes, prince over all the earth.
I will make your name to be remembered from one generation to another.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be.
A reading from the Word of God, written in Romans chapter 17, verses 15 to 25a. I do not understand my own actions, for I do not do what I want, but I do the very thing I hate. Now, if I do what I do not want, I agree that the law is good. But in fact, it is no longer that I do it, but sin that dwells within me. For I know that nothing good dwells within me, that is, in my flesh. I can will what is right, but I cannot do it. For I do not do the good I want, but the evil I do not want is what I do. Now, if I do what I do not want, it is no longer that I do it, but sin that dwells within me. So I find it to be a law that when I want to do what is good, evil lies close at hand. For I delight in the law of God in my inmost self, but I see in my members another law at war with the law of my mind, making me captive to the law of sin that dwells in my members. Wretched man that I am, who will rescue me from this body of death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew.
Glory to Christ.
Jesus said to the crowd, "But to what will I compare this generation? It is like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling to one another. We play the flute for you, and you did not dance. You wailed and you did not mourn. For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say, he has a demon. The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. Yet wisdom is vindicated by her deeds." At that time, Jesus said, "I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent, and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Father, except no one knows the Son except the Father. And no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, my burden is light." This is the Gospel of Christ.
Praise Christ, O Lord.
I speak to you in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Jesus. This morning, rather just now, we came across a reading that has probably been personally claimed or used by many people. Many a Christian who has felt stress, a burden for whatever reason, has claimed this reading for themselves. The context in which these words were written is of little importance in some persons' minds, because in the face of personal struggles, these words whisper hope and comfort into our ears. And these words are, "Come to me, all you that are weary
carrying a heavy burden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. Matthew 11, 28-30. I am sure we can all think of our own burdens and challenges right now. Things from which we long for an ease. Maybe it's a health issue, or the struggle with unemployment, the challenge of reduced salary, the pressure of bills that are overdue, or even the ever-increasing cost of items that make it harder and harder to survive. These and many other things are the yokes that are controlling our lives. And in biblical times, it was no different, particularly for the ordinary people of society. The things which controlled their lives were considered to be yokes. And so Jesus uses this term in his conversation in the gospel for today. Now, in this day and age, a physical yoke is not as common a sight as it was in Jesus' time. But thanks to television, travel, or experience, some of us may be able to picture it. Picture a piece of wood functioning as a harness for a beast of burden. We can envisage the yoke compelling the animal, giving it no choice but to carry its heavy load. The peasant in Jesus' time always had a yoke. Their lives as tenant farmers were governed by the whims and fancies of the landowners. Their circumstances and their way of life only allowed them to live from day to day, just like many people of our time are doing. Their lives were also, in essence, controlled by their religious leaders, who they turned to for advice on how to serve God. Because for all Israelites, living according to Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4-5, was important and known as bearing the yoke of the reign of God. In Deuteronomy 6, verse 4-5 says, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your might." However, rather than being a guide, the teachings of the scribes and the Pharisees had become complicated and difficult to follow. Along with living according to the words of Deuteronomy 6:5, the yoke of 613 commandments were placed upon the people. And so in essence, this yoke had become a burden. Jesus, however, proposes an exchange of yokes to the people. He teaches and demonstrates a way of life, a yoke that differs greatly from the one that the religious leaders taught. He promised a yoke that was easy and a burden that was light. The yoke that he provided and still provides is a simple one. It is the yoke of faith and love. It is one that provides the tools to face any challenge that comes ahead. It is the yoke that helps them to see those around them who are in need, and not simply be guided by the rules and the regulations of the Pharisees, but rather to be guided by love and compassion. It is a yoke that we today need to take upon ourselves as well. We know of this yoke, We know this way of life. There's not a Christian in the world who can honestly say that they don't know about it. Yes, there are those who identify with the Christian faith, but whose lives are not a testimony to this yoke. But because they know, then this failure to take it upon themselves and live as Jesus directs is on them and no one else. When we hear and know, but yet do not live as Jesus instructs us, then we will have to answer for ourselves. When it is time for judgment, we all have to answer for ourselves. When we seriously take Jesus' invitation to take up the yoke he offers us, then our knowledge and experience of his love will not be kept to ourselves. We will instead allow God to guide us in ways to touch the lives of the people who are around us. We will commit ourselves to preaching the gospel not merely with our words, but by our actions. Christian action is what is needed now and always. It is for us to stop looking around at what others are doing or waiting for others to do something first and simply take it upon ourselves to do what we can do. There is a lot of pain in the lives of people that we know and others who may be around us. You know what? They are quite rightly looking to us, the church. It is not for us to be like the Pharisees and weigh them down with rule after rule and restriction after restriction. It is for us to greet them with love, to welcome them and not run them away. The love of God, which they experience through our words, our actions, our direction, and their own experience of God will bring a peace to them that surpasses all understanding. Sometimes there are people who are members of a faith community and end up wondering to themselves why they are not happy or feel at peace, even though they attend an act of worship Sunday after Sunday or Saturday after Saturday. While other members who they know are going through challenges seem more at peace than they are. Now, could it be because they have not begun to truly live out the direction and commandments that Jesus has given us? It is when we embrace Jesus' teachings of love that we will experience the peace and rest that he promises are present for those who take his yoke upon them. So, let's ask ourselves, have we taken his yoke upon us? Yes, he says, come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. But he did not stop there. He gave us a directive. He said, take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, my burden is light. We must think carefully about our lives, our happiness, our level of contentment, and ask, have I taken his yoke upon me? Have I learned from him? Do I pattern his humility and his gentleness? Amidst all of life's challenges, am I experiencing the rest and peace he offers? If I do not, if I live contrary to what Jesus asks, if I do not love God, love my God, and my neighbor as myself, then as much as I profess Christianity with my lips, how can I expect to find true peace? How can I ever expect to find rest for my soul? It is not enough to simply take comfort in nice sounding words like those in this morning's gospel and to quote them. It's not enough. We have to play our part. It is for us to actually live out the Christian life. It is for us to actually be Christians in this world. But the question is, the question will always be, will we? My brothers and sisters, let us think of these things. Amen.
Now stand together as we reaffirm our faith using the words of the next scene.
We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ.
seated or moved for intercessory prayers.
Let us pray. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you. We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our words may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from our misery.
Give to the departed eternal rest. We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our needs and those of others. Almighty God, to whom our needs are known before we ask, help us to ask only what accords to your will, and the good things which we dare not, or in our blindness cannot ask, grant us for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The act of penitence. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just and will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us therefore confess our sins. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and all that we have done, and all that we have left undone. We have not loved you with all of our heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have not loved ourselves as we ought. We are truly sorry.
Almighty God, have mercy upon me. Pardon and deliver me from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen me in all things, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Please stand. We are the body of Christ. By the one Spirit, you are all baptized into one body, and have all been made to drink of the one Spirit. Let us then pursue the fingers and have made for peace, and we let them come. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
morning, brothers and sisters.
Good morning, brother.
Indeed, it's another beautiful day to be worshiping in church, the second Sunday of the lockdown. And we're growing in numbers. Last week we had 18 and we're 20 so far. Not bad, we're growing. And I'm sure those persons are still worshiping and following us on our social media platforms. And looking around, there are no first-time visitors. Midweek devotions, our prayerful midweek refill, continues this Wednesday at 6 p.m. on the various social media platforms. We want to ask for your help to celebrate our children's achievements by sending us the emails with their names and their achievements that they gained throughout the school year. Registration link for church services. Please ensure that we can accommodate as many persons as possible. I think we're currently set up to accommodate at least 50 persons. Yes. So please encourage persons to register and to come out to the service next Sunday, both 7 and 9 a.m. The Center for Theological Leadership Training, their third graduation service, is next Sunday at 4 p.m. and that's at the Church of God Prophecy, Victory Tabernacle, Eastern Avenue, across the road. We'll be presided by Bishop Clayton Martin, who is the president of the Center for Theological Leadership Training, as well in the Caribbean region. The keynote address will be led by Reverend Randy Van Cannon, who is the pastor of the Cayman Islands Baptist Church. Right, the only thing I'll say is on Thursday coming, that's the 9th, we are having our second lecture on financial planning, which is hosted, we are on Zoom, it's a men's fellowship, and this session are being led by our very own brother, Andrew Rollins. It's very, very, very informative, and for all, this session is geared towards men, so if you know any brothers who are not here, or you know anyone who wants to be a part, please reach out to the church office and we will send the link for the Zoom. There are more sessions are coming up for females and for everyone in particular, so don't worry. It's all in the plans. Birthdays, Karen Owens on the 6th and Annalise Shibley on the 11th. Happy anniversary to George and Angela Menz on the 6th, Richard and Leslie and Sigsworth on the 10th. Do have a pleasant day.
Thank you very much, Brother Gerald. Just one reminder that the Blessed Sacrament will be received in one time. Body of Christ, and we place in the palm of your hand. Our offertory hymn, hymn 496.
offer you these gifts which you have given us, this bread, this wine, this money.
With them we offer ourselves, our lives, and our work to become through your Holy Spirit, our resistant, holy, and alive sacrifice. As this bread and wine become the body and blood of Christ, so will you and all your people become channels of your love through the same Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right, a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God. For you are the source of light and life. You made us in your image and called us to new life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Mother God. Hosanna. Eucharistic prayer, please sit for me. Sovereign Lord and Father, to you be glory and praise forever. In your boundless wisdom, you brought creation into being. In your great love, you fashioned us in your image. In your tender compassion, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, to share our human nature. In the power of the Holy Spirit, you overcame the power of sin and death and brought your people to a new birth as first fruits of your new creation. On the night that he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance." And after supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to the command of your dearly beloved Son,
we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory.
And we offer you, Father, our sacrifice of thanks and praise. Send your Holy Spirit on these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, Jesus, our Lord and Redeemer. As we partake of this holy food of new and unending life, may your Holy Spirit establish us as a royal priesthood with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. George, and all your sons and daughters who share in your eternal inheritance through Jesus Christ our Lord. With him, and in him, and through him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. As our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as
we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from the evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Because we all share in one body.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. The gifts of God for the people of God. Our souls will be eased and be satisfied, and we will sing thy sons. Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Eternal God and Heavenly Father,
we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ.
Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage
to love and serve you and all persons in you with gladness and singleness of heart, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
May the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you this day and forevermore. Serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.
Amen. blessed and joyful name of your day, and of course, as well.